Welcome to this release video of our new program, PREFAB-Print. The program works as standalone and can load a model and results from FEM-Design. PREFAB-Print automatically generates a full documentation report for the building elements with attached loads and statical analysis for the whole building. The main program capabilities, easy and fast load takedown and presentation of general stability, both elastic and plastic. A uniform presentation of results from the consultant to the manufacturer. Visual overview of the loads on the single elements. If Prefab Print is open while a calculation is running in FEM-Design, the model is automatically loaded in Prefab Print. Alternatively, the model can be loaded by pressing on this button. In settings, you can define the properties for the company and user. Under project, you can give information about the project and choose to consider the compression area as elastic or plastic. In the model viewer, you can see the construction, and there are several tools to display the desired element or elements. In the documentation setup, you can choose which load combinations to be included in the report. You can add a name for a verifier if necessary, and choose if the report should display tooltips or report verification. The report is generated by clicking on Print. In the report, you can see the calculated load combinations and status for the wall elements. By clicking on an element, a tooltip pops up with information. Loads, reactions, and edge forces are clickable for tooltip information. Detailed calculation conditions and results can be seen in tooltips as well. And the program indicates the necessary tension anchorage in the tension zone to prevent sliding failure. The report is ready to be sent directly to the element manufacturer. In order for Prefab Print to work correctly, you need to follow a series of conditions when modeling in FEM-Design. The walls need to have a constant thickness. That means that the thickness should not vary along the single element. Edge connections need to be set for all connected sides of the walls and for all the walls. Furthermore, both edge connections need to be defined for two connecting walls. In the vertical connection, the KZ degree of freedom is set to 0 for both tension and compression, and KY in tension, which means that the walls cannot transfer tension in their plane and no forces in their perpendicular plane. The KX value indicates the connection stiffness and has to be assessed for each case in particular. A higher value results in the connection taking higher loads. If the plastic limit is indicated in the edge connections, the value is used as the connection capacity in Prefab Print, and the utilization will be shown in the report. In the horizontal connections on the top and bottom of the walls, the detach Y tension function must be used, which ensures that there is no transfer of tension or shear forces in the regions where the wall elements are in tension zone. There will only be shear in the compression zone. Separate end points must be used in all corners. The line supports under the walls are made with detach in Z tension and 0 for KY in tension and compression. Tension anchorage is carried out by trusses. You can create your own cross-section and material strength. Please note that the tension strength is taken as the lowest value in the material yield strengths. Tension anchorage is set under the wall level to ensure that the wall support doesn't take loads from the anchor. The tension anchorage is supported by a point support. Beams must not be placed in the corners, as all corner points are released. We recommend to define stories for each level, so the report will present the walls on levels. Use covers as slabs to distribute surface vertical forces. Horizontal loads are applied as point or line loads on the stabilizing wall. The loads must be assigned to the wall elements that are loaded. Alternatively, they need to be moved a little bit within the wall, otherwise FEM-Design will not know if the loads should be taken by the wall on the top or the one on the bottom.